Hi guys, today I'm going to be doing a kind of a quick overview of one of our newest announced products. It's not the ACS-64, despite what you might think. It's actually the ACS-64 sound card for the R Soundbox system, which I will be demonstrating with the assistance of my lovely assistant here. So I'm going to jump right into it. I'm going to boot us up here. The first thing you'll hear when I turn it on, you're going to hear a couple things. You're going to hear the pantograph go up. You'll hear the compressor turn on. You'll hear the transformers start humming. You'll hear the machine room blower. What you'll probably also hear is a cab alert beep. It goes off about every 60 seconds while the power is on. It's there in the prototype model as well. It's there to kind of keep the engineer alert, because in reality, this engine does make a whole lot of noise on the inside. So, being an electric engine, so I'm just gonna go ahead and boot this up. Alright, so a couple things about the way this sound card works. It does have momentum built in. Unlike the diesels, the sound profile of the prime mover follows the speed of the engine, kind of like our steam locomotives, rather than the profile of the throttle. So you will hear it naturally kind of go up and down as it goes around curves. So I'm going to just zoom us out here a little bit, so you can get a good view of my operation here. Kind of get an idea of what it's doing as it's going around. So without any further ado, let's take it for a spin. I'm going to close the doors here. Brake release. This little toot. So you hear that hum, and you hear that hum kind of go up and down a little bit as it kind of reaches the curves and slows down a little. It's all naturally built into the way it works. You can adjust it, how you want by using the synchronization knob on the sound box. And then if you hit the 6 button on the sound box, you'll go into more of a silent mode. This is what you would expect when it's not accelerating or anything like that, or using its regenerative braking. It's just coasting along at a constant speed through the countryside. So in addition, obviously we've got horns, we've got bells, we do have a brake squeal, we do have a coupler clank sound while it's in motion, and like I said before, we have the coasting function here. So, in addition, we have, see if I can bring it to a stop in the station here. Ooh, it missed. Let's try that again. In addition, we've got our opening and closing doors. There's two individual sounds. And you can also use the same button which enabled the coasting function will actually turn the raise and lower the pantographs, or sound-wise anyway, which will shut the entire engine off, obviously. While it's like this, obviously the throttle doesn't work. It's a dead locomotive, no power, so we'll just turn that back on. Thank you. think the sound card will really add a lot of sort of enjoyment to your operation of the ACS-64. All the sounds are recorded by the engineers at Soundtracks from the Sacramento test track, where they test the real locomotives. So everything's prototypical. Yeah, so that's it. Look for the sound cards coming in November. Individual ACS-64 releases themselves will also be coming shortly after. But for now, you will be able to, at least for 1 month, you'll be able to enjoy the sound card with your ACS-64 and AmFleet passenger car sets. So, thanks for watching, and hopefully those of you out there with the Soundbox and be able to pick this up if you've got an interest in the ACS-64. If you didn't before, hopefully you have some now. So, yeah, thanks for watching.